Apulia, the heel of Italy's boot. A region instantly recognizable for the traditional conical roofs, known as Trulli, that date back to the time people were so poor they lived with their animals. And for the product that lifted them from this grinding poverty, olive oil. Italy is second only to Spain as the world's largest producer of what the locals think of as liquid gold. And the best of that Italian oil is here in Puglia. But a terrible infection has been rampaging through the olive groves of this region, killing almost every tree it touches. It's called Xylella, and even magnificent olive trees that have stood in groves like these for 200, 300, 400 years are not immune. Far from it. We found this tragic graveyard of ancient olives, planted here probably by a peasant farmer long before Charles I was executed or London was consumed by the Great Fire. Now just firewood themselves. There is neither treatment nor cure for Xylella. Once infected, an olive tree is doomed. Despite the fact it is only thought to have arrived in Puglia in 2013, almost certainly in a consignment of ornamental olive trees from Costa Rica, vast swathes of this province are now a wasteland for olive farmers.
We can show you the devastation in any particular olive grove in any particular part of Puglia, but what's quite hard to convey is that in this part of the world there is barely a square metre of ground that doesn't have an olive tree on it, and you can drive for mile after mile after mile and see nothing but this, the carcasses of dead trees, many of them hundreds of years old.
As many as 15 million trees, a quarter of the olives grown in Puglia, are estimated to have died in just these last 8 years. And what has been devastating for the trees has frequently been tragic too for those who grow them. Giovanni Melcane has seen his groves decimated. His response has been to work tirelessly to test, identify and develop species of olive tree that carry a natural resistance to the Xylella bacterium.
In questa serra un ingresso di parecchie cultivar di tutta Italia, le più importanti, e le abbiamo inoculate al fine di verificare nel tempo il comportamento di queste piante a Xylella.
There are just two known varieties of tree that are resistant to this infection. Working with some of Italy's top biologists, he's grafting and crossbreeding young trees to try and find more.
Cultivar nostre autoctone. Cioè l'obiettivo qual è? Avere una pianta con le caratteristiche tecnologiche della cellina di Nardò, dell'Oliarola Salentina, che sono quelle che stanno seccando per Xylella, però con i geni della resistenza delle cultivar che sono state trovate resistenti.
Giovanni is replanting with resistant trees, but the rest of Italy, in fact all the olive growing regions of Europe, are potentially vulnerable to Xylella, carried by the spittlebug, a common flying insect that feeds on an infected tree, becoming infected itself and spreading it to the next.
And if you want to understand how difficult it is to control this infection, here is one of the spittlebugs that transmit it, attaching itself to a car. They can get onto a car at anything up to 50 miles an hour and go, well, just as far as you're going.
Pier Federico Lanotte is a scientist at Bari University in Puglia, working hand in hand with farmers like Giovanni to find a solution.
So these are varieties that have grown spontaneously. They haven't been cultivated, and that may have built up their own natural resistance.
Yes, we making selection, going in the field and looking at plants, thousands and thousands of plants born for seed, we could, our objective is to find variety that are resistant.
The importance of stopping and then reversing this infection is not just agricultural and economic. In Puglia, it is profoundly cultural.
So very gingerly, start bringing in the outside just your finger.
Silvestro Silvestori runs a wine and cookery school in the city of Lecce. An Italian-American who has come back to his roots here in Puglia, he teaches students from all over the world about local pastas, grape varieties, and most of all about Puglia's olive oils.
It's seen as money in the bank. So if you have this year's harvest and you know you have oil, everything else, you can sigh and know that you're going to get through the year.
This is Puglia.
try to find someone who doesn't cry when talking about this. Yeah, these old trees that have many of them are pre-Christian, right? Go very far back, and it's fast. I mean, you can drive down the road, you know, go away for the weekend, and next you come back and you can see the difference.
Further north in Puglia, they are trying to build something of a barrier to prevent Zilella moving ever onwards up the Italian peninsula.
And this is your task for today?
Yes.
And these stripes?
Yesterday and today.
Italy's forest police, now part of the elite Carabinieri force, patrol farms and small holdings to enforce proper ground clearance and plant hygiene.
The ground has to be without grass.
An adult spittlebug will lay its eggs in the grass or on weeds, where they will then develop through the spring until, as adults themselves, they're able to fly into the trees. If you can clear the ground of all greenery, that life cycle can be broken. Have you noticed a slowdown in the spread of this disease?
Al momento non registriamo un avanzamento, salvo alcuni isolati casi, ma sono casi isolati, possono essere praticamente considerati solo tre, che comunque sono stati prontamente, come dire, circoscritti, e rispetto a queste situazioni si è creata una cortina di sicurezza, per cui attualmente, insomma, il fenomeno non ci risulta che sia in avanzamento.
Vincenzo Lucarello's family farm is so far mercifully free of Zilella, and he is determined to keep it that way.
So this field looks very, very clean, Vincenzo. Why have you done that?
Long time ago, my grandfather said, Vincenzo, don't forget, most of bacteria reproduce in the grass, in the herbs.
Given the plight of other parts of Puglia, Vincenzo is philosophical about the future.
We try to protect in the best way, but if the disease will be here, we have to see what to do.
What would you do if the disease came here?
It's like when we get the cancer, we don't know what to do. We don't know. It's a big problem. It's a really big problem.
The man who leads the regional government here, Michele Emiliano, is confronted daily by the economic costs of this disease and haunted by the thought of how much worse it could get if it's not controlled. But he's also realistic about the fact that Puglia is never likely to rid itself completely of this infection.
Noi abbiamo scoperto questa malattia nel 2013 e da quel momento era come se un mostro dallo spazio fosse arrivato a colpirci alle spalle. Noi dobbiamo trovare il modo di convivere ormai con la xylella, non possiamo eradicarla, non possiamo farla sparire, dobbiamo convivere.
Vivere con, non vivere,
vivere
senza.
Vivere con la xylella.
Learning to live with the Xylella bacteria, right now that's the prospect for Vincenzo Lucarello. One day it may be too for growers across Europe if containment doesn't work. If this disease were to become endemic everywhere, this oil we take for granted will become much rarer and even more expensive. Liquid gold indeed.